Somebody shut that damn music off! Don't walk in front of the freaking frame, cameraman!
We really need to stop hiring these kids off the streets.
Yeah, I know!
But we don't have
How
enough money!
How do we find these
We don't have enough money
to actually hire a freaking professional cameraman!
We don't! We don't! We just don't! End of story. We make barely anything. Mike, what? What's your salary here?
Oh my
God. I'm lucky I'll make $15 a week here.
God, I know, seriously. God, it's like I make like five. God, I make like $5 a week, man. Like.
No, don't lie. Don't you lie to me. Don't you lie to me. Don't you lie to me. Because I was talking to your wife, Candy, when I saw her at the strip club last week, and she told me that you have some type of bonus where you get $15 to $20 more than I do because, for some reason, all right, Steve Knickerbocker, our co-producer, he wants you to come to his office after the shows, and it's just some weird stuff, dude. So I'm on to you, Milky. I am on to you. Anyway, now that we're 5 minutes into the damn show,
okay,
we're on the air.
Fans,
the people of America are trying to get their
fantastic
news.
Fantastic! So welcome to the third episode of the QVC News, being broadcast live on the interweb.
Streamed on the interweb. I am Evan Wadsworth, and this is my good friend and co-analyst,
Milky Cabrera.
Thank God you remembered your name this time.
Me, which is kind of weird. Anyway.
At least my wife doesn't strip. Anyway, folks, it has been quite some time. I think the last episode we put out online was sometime in July.
Yes.
Man, that's
yes,
a long
I believe
time
so.
Ago. July.
Yeah,
you realize that's almost a year ago.
I know, man. It's
what
April.
What these people have been doing? They've been waiting and clawing and scratching and hoping that there'd be another episode sometime soon.
Yeah, I know, man.
And you know the good thing? The good thing about filming an episode right now, here in our bungalow down in South Africa, in some guy's basement, we do not have to listen to that damn pool filter in the background. So you can clearly hear our voices.
Thank God it's not summer! We don't have to listen to that shit anymore.
Okay. Back to what I was going to say earlier. Anyway. We are going to try our best, because as this is a children and family-friendly show, we will stop dropping F-bombs and swearing, Milky.
Oh, right.
Family friendly gets more money.
Oh, right.
Anyway.
Money.
Okay. Money's good. Monday means that your wife won't have to strip as much on Wednesdays. Middle of the week, Milky.
I know.
Worst talent ever.
I know.
Anyway. Now that I've gone on that rant as long as I can take it, it is April. It is April 19th, probably sometime around, oh God, I don't know, noon almost? Yes, it's 11:51 in the morning.
Oh, yes.
And you are tuned into the QVC News, 10 o'clock news at 12 o'clock. Milky, we're 2 hours late for the news. Whatever, I was able to dig up some news, folks. First story, moonwalking lawmaker told to put dance shoes away. This is in Bucharest, Romania. The hell would you ever want to go to Bucharest for? Anyway, a moonwalking politician might not be the best reason to pay attention to Romanian politics, but the antics seem to be working. Edmund Talmakarin A 40-year-old Bucharest politician has inspired national headlines with his Michael Jackson-inspired moonwalk on a television show and his impersonations of the late dictator Nicolae Corso. His impersonation of a well-known sports commentator during a serious political debate also stunned other lawmakers into silence. God dang it, will you be quiet? We need to stop hiring these cheap-ass, no-talent camera people.
I know!
Studio people.
How do we find these people?
The lighting is just piss poor in this place.
I know! It's awful! All we have are these light bulbs at odd intervals in the room.
You don't have to yell, it's because I'm yelling.
Not getting paid much here.
Yeah, anyway.
You don't get paid anything if you don't shut up!
Back to the story.
Anyway, dancing is another kind of political message to appeal to the younger generation. That is a good to have fun. That is it, good to have fun. You know what?
You know what?
This story just sucks. I don't even know if I should continue with it. It's stupid. It's from Romania. Who cares? Anyway, that story was from the Associated
Press. Why don't we just go to the audio footage?
No, we're not going to go to the audio footage yet. It's our best stuff.
Oh, right.
Not yet. Anyway, jeez. Anyway. What are you doing? You're readjusting. I'm sure it's immensely sweaty under there. I really don't want to know what's going on under there, but anyway. In and out, young. In and out.
Okay, huh?
Okay, the QVC News is unofficially brought to you by Bud Light and everything else you see in this room. Miller Lite somehow put their name up here. It's kind of a clash of titles. It shouldn't be there. But Pablo, our fat cameraman who has no talent, is rubbing his belly right. You won't get another Miller Lite unless you cut the crap!
Thank you, well.
Anyway, we're also brought to you by Harvard, wonderful people who made this lovely news/air hockey table.
Yes.
Fan fripplin' flippin' flappin'-tastic. I almost swore. I'm trying to make this a family-friendly show. Anyway, we'll go to the first audio clip. Unfortunately, we're so shambled and not prepared for this particular news segment that I have to ask Milky what the first news clip is. So, Milky, without further ado, I'm going to go find the footage.
Oh, yes, yes, friends. So it is finally time to hear...
Milky, 2 minutes till commercial. Pay attention.
So it is finally time to hear Scooter's petition. Everybody.
Hello, this is Ted Schumacher reporting for the QVC News. Coming up next, we have a guy that really loves scooters. So here's what he had to say about scooters.
Hi, my name is Frank Wilcott, and I really enjoy scooters. I got a scooter, and I got a dog whose name is Scooter, and I actually bought a scooter for the dog, and I'm protesting to try to change my name to Scooter Wilcott, and I'm hoping that you will all hear my petition and will want to sign my petition, and... that's pretty much it. I do have a brother named Scooter. He also has a scooter. We actually bought a house recently that we all live in. We call it the Scooter Residence. And the walls are entirely made out of scooter parts. Wheels, frames, T-bars, stanchions. And the TV is made out of scooters too. Don't work too well. Only got one channel. It's a scooter channel. And... that's pretty much it. All right, well, please sign my petition. Frank Wilcott, trying to change my name to Scooter, because I really do enjoy scooters.
Well, what a load of dog crap that was. Anyway, folks, we'll be back after these short messages. Stay tuned to the QVC News, 10 o'clock news. At 12 o'clock, I am Evan Wadsworth with Milky Cabrera. We'll be back in a few.